Hi everyone, I'm Lauren. You may have seen some of my other videos, but I'm here with Peggy Lee, named for the jazz singer, to do some plucking. You can see she's very plucky today, and maybe on the run. My dogs are very interested. Beat it, beat it, beat it. So, we're just gonna pluck and talk about rabbits. Okay, there she is. You can see that she's got just a ton of fluff, and when I start pulling it out, I'll start showing it to you. She is also feeling a little bit skinny under here, so I think she might need some good treats. Penny, calm down, go away. So, without further ado, here is some of Peggy Lee's fiber. I'm not sure how long that is. I'm gonna guess about 4 inches. And it's a very beautiful kind of fawn or light camel color. Her color is called Lilac Tort. Lilac is like the base color gene, and tort is short for tortoiseshell, which is another color gene that makes rabbits have this pattern of their color. So like when she was born, her belly and face was probably a lilac color, which looks pretty similar to blue or black rabbits. But then she's got this lighter back, and then that makes her grow with this light tan fiber. Get down, honey. So here she goes. She's just plucking away. And she's pretty dirty because I've been having her live in like a colony setup in the bunny barn, which means that she's been living with other rabbits, not in a cage, and so she's covered in like hay and stuff like that because they eat and get messy. So this is a beautiful girl plucking away. There's more fiber, and as you'll see, I'm trying to help Angora rabbit farmers that raise their rabbits ethically, trying to help dispel the myth that this is a painful process for them. She would not be afraid to like scream and run away and bite me if this was painful, but I'm just pulling out stuff that's already shed, and she's perfectly happy to just sit here. It actually probably also helps her feel a little bit less encumbered, if you know what I mean. Just coming right out, beautiful stuff here. So I thought that maybe one of the things, Penny, go away. Go away. I know you want a snack, but this is not a snack for you. So I thought, I don't really have an agenda for this video because I've already done kind of an informational barn to yarn thing. So I thought I would just talk about some of the realities of raising rabbits. I've had some struggles of late that we could talk about with the rabbits. So one of the struggles that I've had in the last month or so is fur mites. And these are little parasitic bugs that live on the rabbit and nibble on them. And it makes their hair fall out, which is not necessarily a good thing. And they get like this flaky dandruff on their skin. And my boy, Gershwin, he got it really bad. And I didn't notice what was going on until I saw that he had like big bald spots, because they're not visible bugs, they're mites, just kind of like we have eyebrow mites and stuff. So it's common for rabbits, and it might be, I've never had them before, and I'm wondering if it's from the rescue bunny that I got recently. He might have had some mites and brought it into my barn. Luckily it's pretty easy to treat. There's different ways to do it. I dumped diatomaceous earth all over the inside of my bunny barn, food grade stuff, because that's supposed to kill mites and ticks and stuff like that, but without harming mammals. But I have read a fair amount of stuff about that not being good for the like lungs and respiratory system of the rabbits and causing microscopic tears. So I didn't feed the diatomaceous earth to the rabbits, but what you can do is you can get this stuff called ivermectin, which is meant for pest control for like horses and cows, and you can give a really tiny dose to the rabbits. So I treated Gershwin and he looks to be clearing up, but I'm just noticing right now that it looks like Peggy has the same problem. So I'm gonna have to treat her today too. So I have this bottle of medicine, looks like an old school medicine bottle in brown glass like that. And then these little syringes, and you just put like a couple drops in their mouth once today. I'll give her another dose in 2 weeks and that should clear the whole thing up. So it's a bummer. Her skin right here, I won't show you because it's kind of gross. It's like, it looks like it has dandruff basically. So that's a telltale sign of the mites. And when it gets really bad, I think their skin gets all red and angry looking, and she's not there luckily. So we'll just clean her up and then we'll treat her. And she should be feeling a lot better pretty soon. Now she might have gotten them because I put her and Gershwin together for a romantic date night on Valentine's Day. I'm hoping to get a beautiful litter of babies out of these guys. That is probably a good segue to one of the other struggles that I've been having, and that is fertility in the bunny barn. So I have 8 rabbits in total, 4 Angora rabbits, and then 4 of them that I raise for meat. So I keep, generally, I've been keeping the Angoras each in their own cages so that their fur stays cleaner. And if you could, you probably can't see, but if you could see all of the little bits of hay in her coat, you would understand why I was doing that. But I've been trying to breed both the meat rabbits and the Angoras for babies. So for the Angoras, I want to breed them so that I can have more of them and harvest more fiber, but also I might be like one of the only Angora rabbit breeders in Utah. I know of one that does English Angoras that is an hour north of me, but otherwise it's like impossible. And there are lots of people here and in surrounding states that are looking for rabbits of their own. And I always have people asking for kits. So I'm trying to breed to pass on the rabbits to those people as well. And you can see the kind of dandruffy skin here, maybe that's where the skin mites are. Anyway, I'm having issues, A, with the does wanting to breed, so I'll put them together and have them spend the night together, and we all talk about people reproducing like rabbits when they have a lot of children. These rabbits are very prude. They're little celibate rabbits. So I try to get them to breed, and you would think that it would be like out of control and I had more rabbits than I ever wanted, but amazingly, like, ladies aren't wanting to breed, the men are trying their best, and then the ladies don't conceive, so there's no babies. And then a couple of times I've had these rabbits who hid their pregnancies from me, like the babies were so up high that I couldn't feel them, and then they delivered not in a nest and the babies all died, and that was also heartbreaking. So that's happened once or twice, and that is like such a bummer, because not only am I sad about the like dead little baby rabbits, but I also am really sad that I didn't get the babies that I wanted to keep. So I did a bunch of breeding on Valentine's Day. I paired up 4 pairs of boys and girls, and I'm really hoping to get a litter. And I also, no, so it's 3 pair, because I have one rabbit that is my meat rabbit that's currently pregnant. And I can, when I feel her belly, I can feel like a fully formed kit in there. It's probably that big, and you can feel the head and then the shoulders. Get down, get down, get down. So I know she's due any day. So I have a nest box in there for her, and I've been keeping her well stocked with water and hay, and I'm just really hoping for a successful litter this time. Penny, you gotta relax. Get down, get down, get down. There we go. So we're just plucking away. I do it kind of slowly, and I don't always do it all at once because I have rheumatoid arthritis, which causes, among other things, arthritis. So sometimes my hands are a little too sore to do a whole rabbit at once, but I'm doing okay right now. So that's another challenge to raising animals, is having an arthritic body in your very early 30s. sometimes I just don't feel up to doing certain like little farm chores. For example, most of these guys are in cages and the rest of them all live in a little barn together while the cages are in the barn. So I have to clean that out very regularly. And I haul the rabbit waste as fertilizer into my garden box and dump it in there. And that doesn't sound like a really big job because I only have 8 rabbits and it's just in the same yard. But sometimes like my back, my shoulders just can't take the lifting and the dumping and the carrying and stuff. So that's always a bummer. But for the most part, I'm thankful to have good medical insurance through my job because the medical intervention that I have tends to work pretty well. So that's not interesting to a lot of people, I'm sure, but it's what I go through every day. So I rent a house in Salt Lake City. It's kind of a suburby area of Salt Lake, and there's a really big shed out in the backyard, and that's what I call the bunny barn, and it's designated just for rabbit housing. I tried a bunch of other types of arrangements out in the yard to raise the rabbits. Like I built a giant rabbit mansion out of PVC pipe and chicken wire. Not your snack. But on a really windy day, we're having a big storm. And it wasn't like adequately staked into the ground. So it fell over and the PVC pipe all broke. Penny, get down! And the rabbits got out and I was chasing them all around the neighborhood. And luckily the dogs weren't out at the same time because as you can see, the dogs want to eat the rabbits. So that was a mess. Hi, you're so cute. Are you here to give me some cuddles? Give me some cuddles for you. Thank you. That mean dog's carrying you? You're skinny. I'm gonna give you a banana. Yeah, I'm gonna give you a banana. What a cute girl. So being that she's in kind of a... Penny, go away. Being that she's in kind of a colony setup with two other rabbits, they might be kind of beating her out for food right now. So, stop it. So she might not be getting all the food that she wants. When it's in a cage and there's only one rabbit per food bowl, it's really easy to make sure that they're getting all the feed that they need. But she's feeling pretty thin, so I'm wondering if the other rabbits are kind of bullying her away from the food bowls. So I'll keep her in after we're done with this and give her some treats to fatten her up a little bit. I feed my rabbits pellets from the local ranch supply store that are just meant for rabbits. Penny, you gotta relax. You're fine. And then I also feed them as much Timothy hay as they want. And then I just give them tons and tons and tons of kitchen scraps. So there's some fruits and vegetables that rabbits can't eat, and some that you have to be kind of sparing with, like anything with a high sugar content. But if I, you know, I'm making a salad and I have half of a head of lettuce where I cut it off from the stalk, I'll bring that out, and like tomatoes, berries. I have a neighbor who has apple and pear trees, and sometimes I'll go get tons of apples like from the ground and just give them the whole apples and the whole pears and stuff. So not only is it not rotting on my friend's lawn, but it's delicious for them. So I love trying to reduce waste as much as I can because I'm a hippie. And that's one or two of the ways that I do that. And then obviously, like in the summer, our yard is just full of dandelions. So I pick as many dandelions as I can anytime that I'm outside and bring those to them. They love dandelions and they're really good for them. And then, you know, then I'm taking weeds out of my lawn, feeding my rabbits with them. And then the rabbits, you know, make their little bunny pellets that become wonderful fertilizer. I think there are people that bag and sell the rabbit pellets. And that might be worth looking into, I think. I don't know, maybe I could get like $5 a bag for it or something. It would be nice just to have. have a little extra cash towards rabbit food. Because they're not cheap little creatures. Oh, you cute girl. So I just did my taxes, and I'm not like registered or as a farm or anything. And the business is just labeled as like handmade goods sale, I guess, whatever. And so I didn't find a way to deduct the feed from the costs, but I'm probably next year gonna keep better track of like what I spend on feed and try to deduct that as an expense. I didn't keep any receipts this year because I didn't think of it. But given that I sell the fiber from these rabbits, and maybe when I have more meat rabbits, I might make things out of the pelts so as not to waste any of the rabbit and make things out of those. So I should really, you know, like that's an expense into developing the good. But I don't know a whole lot about taxes, and I don't know if it would be worth like trying to register this as a little fiber farm, because there might be tax breaks that are relevant or something. I don't know. You might want to look into that. If any of you know about taxes for farms, please let me know. Penny. So far, just sitting here in the last couple minutes, I've got all of this. I would estimate that that's probably about 2 ounces, and I still have halfway to go. I did most of her back. I'm now working on this side. I've got that side. That you can look at her belly. Oh, hey, you're okay. So there's actually a lot of fiber right there that I can plug into. Okay. I didn't mean to scare you. You're fine. Penny, this has nothing to do with you. And you stay away from that. It is a Monday, and normally I would be at work right now, but it's President's Day. And so I'm hanging out at home, keeping up on the dishes, hanging with my little family, my daughter. You're hogging all the attention. My daughter's taking a nap right now, so I have what I thought was a relatively quiet hour or so to do this. I was mistaken. And my husband's working from home in the other room. We've had a really dry winter, like with almost no snow, and that's really bad for the economy of Utah because we rely a lot on ski resorts for tourism. And then last night, it was like, you know, 9 o'clock when I looked out the window, no snow on the ground. And then at 10 o'clock, all of a sudden we have 2 inches and it's everywhere. So we have, I think we probably have 6 to 8 inches right now outside. And I had to like dig a little path to the bunny barn, checking to see if there's babies first thing this morning, which there are not yet. And then we had a nice, cute little 13-year-old girl come to the door and ask if she could shovel our driveway. And at first we were like, oh, somebody out like doing service for the community, but she wanted to get paid. So we were very happy to let her shovel our driveway for a couple dollars. It was a smart, enterprising 13-year-old. I think Penny's laying on the floor next to me now. She's calming down and realizing that this is not about her. My other dog, Reggie, is pretty oblivious to what's going on. He's just laying in the kitchen, dreaming of food. Because he's a food-motivated little guy. And then we also have a cat to control our mice situation, and he's probably on my husband's lap or something right now while he's working. Clingiest cat I ever met. And then, as if this wasn't enough of a menagerie, we have a betta fish. Pretty low maintenance pet. As promised, banana for the rabbit. She might not be willing to eat it with the dog around. see you eat them. People want to see it. There. Nothing cuter than a bunny eating a banana, right? Normally you wouldn't want to give a whole banana to a rabbit, but she looks underweight, so I'm giving her as much as she wants right now. Spread the rest amongst her friends. And then I'll probably have to figure something out to make sure that she's getting enough food. I check on my rabbits, you know, health and well-being every day to some extent, but you do have to check on them pretty regularly just to make sure that their teeth aren't overgrown and their nails aren't too long and they don't have mites or whatever types of little infections they can get. Rabbits are prone to a lot of stuff. And so doing this plucking made me realize that she had fur mites, so I'll treat that today. But it's funny with the Angoras, they have such big fluffy coats that you can't always tell that they're underweight right away until you really are having a look at them, because you can't tell by just looking. You have to kind of feel them and all that, so. Oh yes, you have a banana. Want some more? Really nothing cuter than a rabbit eating, so we're just gonna enjoy this. Every time I feed them out in the barn, like all three of the rabbits that are in the more colony setup, I do always see them eating at the same time out of the same big dish. So I didn't have any reason to think she wasn't getting fed enough. No. Oh, I hear the cat. Bowser! No. Bowser! I think Peggy hears the cat too. I think she's pretty distracted by all the animal noises. She might feel like she's in a little bit of danger. So I'm probably gonna cut her nails pretty soon and then bring her back out to the barn. She still has about half of her, whoa, look at that. She still has about half of the plucking left to be done, but this video is getting kind of boring, I think. So, we'll move on. All right, so to cut the nails, I just have the regular tape. All right. I have the regular dog clippers, and you just clip the same way that you clip a dog's or a cat's nails, so you can see where the quick is generally. Someone gave me the advice to do like 3 taps with the clippers before you actually cut, because the rabbit will probably shy away if it's too close to the quick. So I do that. I do 3 little taps before I pull the trigger. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and you know, they're not pulling away. I've only nicked a rabbit one time too close to the quick, so I feel pretty good about that track record. I had not had such a good track record with my dogs, I have to admit. Okay, you're all right. Some people like to do this, like put the pantyhose over the paws and the nails come out of the holes of the pantyhose or something. I don't find that necessary for myself, but whatever people need to do, so whatever. 1, 2, 3. Okay, no blood there, so now I'm gonna do those back paws. You're okay. Yeah, you're fine. Oh, she's a little testy. This is the grumpiest rabbit I've ever had, as far as like, so in Bambi, Thumper thumps his foot on the ground when he's happy or whatever. This rabbit thumps her paw on the ground when she is unhappy. And, you know, I shuffle their cages a fair amount for different like breeding reasons and everything. And every time I move her to a different cage or a different area, she just thumps and thumps and thumps to let me know that she is not delighted with the decision that I made. And so I would not be at all surprised if she started thumping right now. Her back end's looking a little dirty, so I might have to clean that out too, but I will not put that on video because no one's interested in that. Okay, hey, I gotta do your nails. Here's your banana. Stop fussing. Ooh, that was a big nail. She's got some really thick nails back here. I would not want to get scratched by one of these. Which is just one reason to cut the nails of your friendly pet rabbits. Okay. I got you. You're fine. It's not gonna hurt you. I do it carefully. Okay. Some rabbits are more amenable to being manipulated. This one is not right now. Penny, get away. Has nothing to do with you. So she's a little bit, another reason that she's a little bit dirty right now is because rabbits like to eat, you're sweet. Rabbits like to eat snow sometimes. It's like hydrating, and so I shoveled a bunch of snow into the bunny barn and just let them have at it. And so that can kind of get them a little bit muddy around the paws. You're fine, Penny. So she's just a cute girl. And you do have to pluck the bellies. And some rabbits will let you flip them over and like lay them down. Obviously, this is not a lady that is gonna do that. So what I usually do is hold them like this. Hey, you're fine. Like under the upper arms, and that way her belly's exposed, which is a bad place for her to be with a dog around in her mind. So she's scared right now. I'm probably not gonna do this for too long. But Penny, there you have it. And now any of you that were thinking about getting rabbits and have a dog might have changed your mind. She's scared. Okay, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this video of a bunny eating.